Good morning, student. Today we are going to discuss chapter 9, algebraic expression and identities, worksheet 9, question number 1. In this worksheet 9, question number 1 have, using suitable identities, evaluate the following. Using suitable identities, evaluate the following. So first part of question number 1 is given here. You can see on the whiteboard. Square of 105. So also you can find in very well, square of 105 is equal to what? 105 into 105. Okay. So if you multiply it and you can find the solution, you can find the answer. But here question told to us that use suitable identities. So first we convert this 105 to 100 plus 5. You can write it 100 plus 5. Okay, whole square of 100 plus 5. This is clear? Now, after this student, you can write here the first identity. What is the first identity? First identity is that whole square of a plus b. Whole square of a plus b is equal to what? You can see here 100 plus 5. Whole square of 100 plus 5. This is equal to what? So here, this is a first identity, whole square of a plus b. You know very well the whole square of a plus b is equal to what? Whole square of a plus b is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. This is clear. So if you compare this and this, you get here, this is a is equal to 100 and b is equal to what? 5. B is equal to 5. So here square of a plus square of b plus 2 into 2ab means what? 2ab means 2ab. This is equal to 2 into a into b. Clear? So a square means square of 100. B square means square of 5. 2ab means 2 into 100 into 5. Because here we compare the both quantities, then we get a is equal to 100 and b is equal to 5. So here we is first identity, whole square of a plus b. This is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. This is clear? Now, so let's see. How can we explain it? So according to this identity number 1, we can express it square of 100 plus 2 into 100 into 5 plus square of 5. Clear? Square of 100 plus 2 into 100 into 5 into square of 5. Okay, now so then square of 100 means square of 100 in the variable, this is equal to 100 into 100. So how you multiply it? This is very simple multiplication of this. Here you write 1 into 1, you get 1. Of this 1, 2, 3, 4, you write. This is 4, 10,000. So you can see square of 100 is equal to what? 10,000. And you will write 10,000. Clear? Now, plus 2 into 10, 2 into 5, 10, 10 into 100, this is equal to 1000. 10 into 100, 1, 2. So, first multiply to 1 into 1, 1, and 1, 2, 3, 0 back here. Clear? So, again 1000 into 5, So you get here 5000. 5000 plus
square of 5 is equal to what? Square of 5 is equal to 25.
25.
Clear?
Now, so if you add them, 10,000, 5,000, 15,000, okay, and 25. 25.
15,000, 25.
So, if you can write, this is equal to 100 plus 5, square of 100 plus 5, this becomes square of 105. This is equal to 15,025.
Clear? So in this question, we use the identity, suitable identities, and evaluate square of 105. So which identity we use here? Obviously, we discussed that first identity is whole square of a plus b.
This is the first identity, whole square of a plus b is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. This is the whole square of
a plus b. This is the first identity. This identity we used here and we find the value of square of 105 is equal to 15,025. This is clear.
So student, first we stress 105. This is equal to 100 plus 5. Clear? 105. First we express it 100 plus 5. Okay, so here this is square, so also we can write it square. After this we compare this quantity, this quantity. So we get here a is equal to 100 and b is equal to 5. So we put the value of a here and the b here. Okay, so we get this number square of 100 plus square of 5 plus 2 into a 100 into b 5. Okay, so in this way we simplify this and we find we evaluate 105 square of 105 is equal to 15,025. This is clear. Now let's see.
The second part of this question is given, square of 97. Question told us that using suitable identity, evaluate square of 97. So let's see how to solve this question.
Square of 97, this is the second part of question number 1. CC worksheet 9. Okay, so here this is given second part of 97,
square of 97.
So student, you can write it 100 minus 3, square of 100 minus 3. So you can see minus and here square, so already this is two terms, their square of their difference. Here a minus b whole square.
So you apply here second identity. What is second identity?
Second identity is that whole square of a minus b. This is second identity. This is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. If you compare both quantity, this quantity and this quantity, then you find that a is equal to what? A is equal to 100 and b is equal to what? B is equal to 3.
Clear? Now, if you put the value of a and b in this identity, second identity, then you will get the square of 97. Okay?
So here you put the value of 100 into 3 in this identity, this is second identity. Okay? So we get, after putting the value of a and b, it's equal to 100 minus 3. Whole square of 100 minus 3, we get that point. And here this is equal to square of 100 clear minus 2 into a is 100 into 2 is 3 plus square of b is square of 3.
This is clear?
Now, so student, square of 100 is equal to what? Square of 100 is equal to 10,000 because 100 into 100. So how much is 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros and 1 into 1, this is equal to 1 and 4 zeros. Was 10,000, 10,000.
So square of 100 is equal to what? 10,000.
This is clear? Now,
after this here you can see 2 into 100, 200, 200 into 3, 600. So write here
600. Here plus
square of 3, you know very well, 3 into 3, this is equal to what? This is equal to 9.
Here is equal to 9.
Clear? So if you subtract them, this is 10,000, this is 6. So first we add them, after this you subtract.
So 10,000 plus 9 is equal to what? 10,009 minus 600. Okay? So here you subtract this. So 9 minus 0, there will be 0, 0 minus 0, again we get 0. This is 0 minus 6. So we carry it on, this will become 10, 10 minus 6, you get here 4, and this becomes 9. Okay? So in this way, then we find the value of 100 minus 3, whole square of 100 minus 3 is equal to 9,400,
or you can say
97. Square of 97 is equal to 9,400. Square, this is 9, this is 9, and here also 9. Clear? So this way you can find the value of square of 97. Okay?
Now, the next question of this, question number 1, this is given 87, square of 87 minus square of 30. We need to evaluate it with using suitable identities. Okay? So let's see how to solve this question.
First we raise them, after this we solve third part
of this question number 1.
Student, I hope all of you understood the first part and the second part of question number 1 by using
the identity.
Okay, now this is the third part. Okay.
Third part is
square of 87 minus square of 30.
We need to simplify this, we need to evaluate it, we need to find the value of this by using suitable identities. So student, if you see this, also you remember that difference of 2 square. This is third identities.
Difference of 2 square. What is difference of 2 square? A square minus B square. This is equal to what? This is equal to A plus B into A minus B.
Clear?
So if you compare this and this, then we get A is equal to what? 87. And b is equal to what? B is equal to 30. So if you put the value, this is equal to, this becomes a square minus b square, so a plus b a minus b. So first we add the 87 plus 30. Second we subtract them. 87 minus 30.
This is clear? 87 plus 13 and 87 minus 30. Okay,
now, so If you add them, 87 plus 32 to what? 87 plus 32 to 100 into subtract them. 87 minus 13 is equal to 74. 74. Clear? Now, see then, here we have, if you multiply 100 into 74, then you get what? You get here, that is 74 into how much you want to. Because 74, 1 plus 74, and here we have 2 0, that is 2 0. So in this way you can see, find 7400. So at last we can write here, square of 87 minus square of 13, this is equal to 7400. Okay. So if we use the third identity, what is third identity? Third identity is that a square minus b square, this is equal to a plus b into a minus b. This is clear? Now, so student, we are going to discuss next questions of this CCE worksheet 9. I repeat again this question. Question just told us that using the suitable identities and evaluate the following. So this is the third part of question number 1. Fourth part of question number 1 is that 105 into 107. Here we not direct multiply it, we need to use identity. After this we find the product of 105 into 107. This is clear. So let's see how to solve these questions. Now, so I hope all have understood this question. Third part of question number 1. Now, this is fourth part of question number 1. Let's see what happened in fourth part of question number 1. We have here 105 into 107. Student, also you can write it. This is equal to what? 100 plus 5 into 100 plus 7. Okay? This is equal to 100 plus 5. Into 100 plus 7, you can write it. Now, so which identity you used here? Fourth identity. So what is the fourth identity? Fourth identity is x plus a into x plus b. This is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. Here, x plus a, x plus b into is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. This is clear. Now, so student, if you compare the both these entities, so you can see this is equal to what? This is equal to 100, x. Because here is x, x and here is also x. So this is equal to x, and in first bracket this is a 5, here this is a, and here this is b, this is 7. So if you compare both, okay, so you get x is equal to what? 100, x, x, so yeah, 100, 100, okay. A is equal to what? 100 plus 5, you have x plus a, so a is equal to 5. Clear? Now, after this, b is equal to what? B is equal to 7. Okay? So, then we apply this identity, fourth identity, and we solve these questions. Okay? So, if you put here, x in the place of x 100, in the place of a 5, into the place of a again 100, in the place of b 7, this is equal to s square. S square means what? The value of s is 100. So here you get 100 square plus 5 is 5 plus b is 7 into x, x is 100 plus a into b, a into b gives what? 5 into 7.
Clear? So,
square of 100 you know very well, 10,000, it's become 5 plus 7, 12.
Okay? 12 into 100
plus 12 into 100 is equal to what? 1200 into 5 into 7.
5 into 7 is equal to
25. So add them. If you add them, it's 10,000, 1,225. So it becomes 11,225. 11,225 is the value of 105 into 107 by using the identity. This is the fourth identity. This is the fourth identity.
X a plus b into x. Sorry, x plus a into x plus b. This is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. This is clear? Okay. You can solve and you will find the product of 105 and 107. This is equal to 11,225. Clear?
Now, so I have studied all of the these questions. You can solve properly by using fourth identity. Okay. So, don't you can write here this is equal to 105. This is equal to, you can write it. This is equal to 100 plus 5 into 100 plus 7. Okay, now, so if you use this identity, x plus a into x plus b, this is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. This is the fourth identity. We use here this identity.
So x is 100 and a is 5, b is 7. So you put according to this identity, we express it like this. So we can write here
square of 100 plus 5 plus 7 into 100 plus a into b, 5 into 7. This is equal to 10,000. This is equal to 1200 plus 25. If you simplify this, then you get 11,225. Okay? So, what is this? This is the value of 105 into 107 by using the fourth identities.
Clear? So, student, I hope all have understood these questions now. We are going to discuss next question. Question number 2. Of this worksheet 9. Let's see what is question number 2.
Question number 2. Question.
Told us that, proved that.
Question number 2. Prove that
what is square of a plus b is equal to
whole square of a plus b. This is equal to whole square of a minus b plus 4ab.
Okay, whole square of a minus b plus 4ab. Okay.
Now, student, you can see here, this is whole square of a plus b, this is equal to whole square of a minus b plus 4ab. We need to, so if you take this is left hand side, this is the right hand side. If you take left hand side, you can say so right hand side. If you take right hand side, then you show it left hand side. If you able to do this, then you can say this is proved. Okay. So here student, this is the left hand side, LHS, and this is the right hand side. So we take your right hand side and try to put left hand side. Right hand side is equal to whole square of a minus b plus 4ab. So with the right hand side and try to prove it, this is equal to left hand side. So let's see. A square b, this is second identity. Whole square of a minus b, this is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. Okay, so you can write here a square plus b square minus 2ab, and here we have 4ab plus i. Okay, now, so 2 minus 2ab plus 4ab, this is equal to what? Obviously, you can say minus 2ab plus 4ab, this is equal to plus 2ab. So we write it a square plus b square plus 2ab, or you can write it a square plus b a square plus 2ab plus b square 2ab plus b square. This is the form of whole square of a plus b, and this is equal to what? This is equal to, you can say left hand side. This is equal to left hand side. Left hand side. So here you can see right hand side is equal to left hand side. So we write here hence, hence proved. Clear? This is clear, student? Now, the second part of this question is that, let's see what is the second part. So I hope all of you understood these questions. Now we are going to discuss second part of question number 2. Second part is also proved that 2a plus 3b whole square, 2a plus 3b whole square plus 2a minus 3b whole square, this is equal to what? This is equal to 8a square plus 18b square. 8a square plus 18b square. Okay. So in this case, then this is the left hand side, this is the right hand side. So here we take left hand side. Left hand side is equal to what? Left hand side is equal to whole square of 2a plus 3b plus whole square of 2a minus 3b. This is right hand side, okay? You can write it. This is right hand side is equal to 8a square plus 18b square. So we take left hand side and try to prove right hand side. Okay, so whole square of this is equal to, this is here we are using first identity. Whole square of a plus b is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So here we use first identity, then we get here 4a square plus, here we get 12ab plus 9b square plus, here we are again get 4a square minus, this is whole square minus 12ab plus again 9b square. Student, here you can see 12 minus 12, this is plus 12, it is cancel. So, okay, and here we get 4a square plus 4a square. 4a square plus 4a square is equal to what? 4a square plus 4a square is equal to 8a square. 8a square. Okay, minus. Plus 9b square plus 9b square, this is equal to what? 18b square. Clear? So, this is equal to what? You can see this is right hand side. So here right, which is a right hand side, and here is a left hand side.
Left hand side is shown right hand side. Then you can see
next row.
So, student, I hope all of you understood this question.